Hello guys. Like always, today is new day, so we will continue with my Birmingham save. As you can see, situation is actually even better what I expected, because we have one game less. So if I win, I will have same point as Cities, as Manchester City. In the last episode, actually I was disappointed with defeat against City and with Stoke defeat, especially against Manchester City at home, because I was much better team. I was just now in the bar, I drink my morning coffee, because last night again I was in the nightclub, like always. And I was a little bit drunk, so now I'm trying to feel much better, and I am really feeling much better. You see, I highly recommend it when it's the winter time to do this alcohol medicine. I think it's the best. As you can see, I'm not sick or I'm not having any flu, so Grey Goose therapy is the best, I will say like that. So let's another important thing is I'm playing against Everton, who is 17 on table, so they are not doing quite well. But I was struggling in away games. Regarding the betting for yesterday, somehow Chelsea managed to qualify. I mean, as I said, I'm not happy with Chelsea team. Especially I was nervous because I was waiting for money that Chelsea will qualify, and when I saw that he is not using first 11, he didn't use 9 standard players, I was deeply concerned. And on end, he was forced to put Hazard, Morata and Kante in. That is telling you how bad is Chelsea bench. And especially Norwich is not even a very, very strong team in my opinion. Actually, I can maybe upload the bet what I was having. When I upload this video on YouTube, I will post picture of that bet from yesterday, just that. Because some people ask me what I bet, I will show you. I can upload the picture. Regarding my Birmingham save. The things what I want to improve is definitely is consistency of comment. I need also that Mr. Jota performs much better in so-called away or big games, because I have feeling that he is doing much better against smaller teams. So excellent start for me, instant goal. Instant reply from Everton. Regarding Pellegrini, as I said million times, this is not going quite well. As I said million times, age is not important. Never mind, he's 17. He has correct attributes and he will play. And, of course, if he is not performing, I will remove him. But for now, I'm happy with his contribution. But I'm not happy with my defense. Especially, I conceded 2 goals in 10 minutes. This is nightmare. And now Adem is having yellow cards. Will I do any changes in the tactic? Maybe in the future, yes. But I need to do a lot of testing, and I'm not happy. I mean, I want to reduce amount of goals what I'm conceding that. I need to see how to improve it more. Maybe I can use some of my team instructions. I don't know even what I'm having currently. Maybe if I change to be more disciplined, I will play much better defensively. I need to think about this one. There is no any contribution currently from my white players in this game. Yeah, he's playing poorly and now yellow card, so I need to replace him, and also Ademi I need to replace. Two yellow cards. And now this fucker score. So as you can see, very, very poor defending. This is what when I'm telling you that I need Carrillero with good long shot, this type of goals. But definitely I want to find a way how I can improve my overall defense with some new team instructions, and that's the plan. Maybe this one to be more disciplined will help me. As you can see, it's now 3-3, very high scoring goal. I'm going now to be more creative, I think. I can do one more substitution, but who will be? I think, as you can see, Jota is not performing. I will put this young British guy. Maybe better was to put Che Adams, but I still feel Coman is my best match winner in this team. Now I will encourage. Because, and you can see now, there is also one option what I was even thinking to use this tactic Pirate Poacher for home game and a little bit to change some things of the same tactic for away game, because I think I'm conceding a lot in away games, and maybe to go in away games to be more disciplined. Just only that thing, all are the same. Maybe one more team instruction. I really need to think about that one. Because when I play home, I don't want to be too much disciplined. I need creativity and some expression in the team. But away game, I need to be more more strong like unit. We will try in the future. Away games, I will try to use more discipline. And Grujic now started to score, that's why I'm telling you. Carriero, his Carriero on the paper is defensive role, but I want the complete midfielder in that role. And that kind of player is not easy to find or to buy. That's the issue. But as I said, this tactic is not very common and requires some kind of certain roles that are not easy to find. Mr. Cohn advised me that I can use also false nine in this tactic, of course, instead of deep lying forward. But when I was creating tactic, I wanted to use deep lying forward just because deep lying forward can play almost every striker. False nine, more or less, but the contribution to build up is the same. Both of them, they stay deep, they spread passes, and they are more assisting and supplying poachers. So, can you survive, please? Regarding poacher up front, I mean, tactic is called Pirate Poacher, so definitely I want to keep poacher. I will never change role of poacher. Please, one good cross for Pellegrini. Trying, and I'm not quietly thinks that tactics what are called plug and play are. I mean, you will need to do some small adjustment with your team, even if it's tactic, it is that type of tactic. So observing is always key. Like for example, maybe Mr. Jota is not performing quite well as shadow striker, even is that natural role, but maybe he will play better as deep lying forward. I mean, these small things, like when I was playing with Deportivo, Romero is by all stats, he's advanced forward or poacher. I was using him as shadow striker because he was missing a lot as poacher. He didn't have enough concentration and composure similar to Che Adams, and then I make him shadow striker. So, as I said, you need to know how to manage your team. That's why I'm always watching the games and trying to observe, you know. If you think that it's possible to win every game with the tactic with lower team, you are wrong. I mean, maybe, but possibilities by percentage is very, very low. So 3-4, good for me. I can just... Okay, this is... and here I can put disciplined, and then I can use maybe this one. I can use away, this at home. I need to a little bit experiment, and I don't want to be this game. I don't want to be bored for me. I mean this Birmingham, so I will try to test some things if possible. So we are in December, as you can see. I'm now playing every few days, so Chelsea, then Southampton away. Regarding this situation with this handball, not so optimistic, because last 10 years normally we lost a lot of gold medals against France, and the biggest factor was their goalkeeper Omeyer, and currently we don't have a good goalkeeper, I mean handball keeper, who can have, let's say, more than 35% of saves. And good goalkeeper is vital in that sport. So I'm not optimistic that Croatia can win gold medal, especially I think the France team is the strongest. Yeah, his long shot is shit. But we will see if he will improve. He's only 17. So you can see I was trying to improve him. Can I try maybe... I don't want this fucking... So I cannot train him finishing move. I will try to shoot with power later on. Chelsea, Southampton, so a lot of big games for me. Do I plan to do Twitch today? Maybe, I mean. December is really tough. Sorry, but he needs to play. So going with same squad. Morata, Hazard, Isco, Willian. So they signed Isco, interesting. Pašalić, he's very good all-round player. I really like him even in reality, because he's midfielder who scores goals. he's too soft to play in this formation. But if I play, let's say, with three classical midfielders. See. Why he's not having shooting? How much is his long shot? 13. He's actually, even in reality, scoring a lot of goals for midfield player. I think currently he plays in Spartak Moscow, yeah? I mean, he's loaned from Chelsea there. He's not playing, so, I mean, for national team in Croatia, it's almost impossible to play if you are midfielder, because players like Modric, Kovacic, Rakitic, Badelj, they are mostly playing, also Brozovic from Inter Milan. Even Kovacic is not playing a lot, so that's our issue. We have a lot of good midfielders, but they are all very similar profile. We are not having any defensive midfielder, for example, or I mean classical defensive midfielder, or some other position we lack like left back or let's say left-footed inside forward on the right side who can play if we are using wide players. I mean, we have Halilović, but his career is falling down. I forgot to replace Roberts in the first 11. This is a really big blow for me that Coman cannot train, cannot have finishing move. So I will try with shoot with power if possible. We will see if I need to replace Saar with Roberts, and for central defender condition is not so important. Do not lose the ball. Pass left. Okay, good one good cross, please. Who was hitting this? Is it Coman? Regarding Alexis Sanchez situation, actually I think maybe for him is the best to stay in Arsenal. That's my honest opinion, because the big clubs like Paris, Barcelona, Real Madrid, Bayern Munich, he cannot play in these big clubs. He is not having that kind of quality. I mean, when I mean cannot play, I mean he cannot play in first 11, or they have better players for position what he is playing. How he can play in let's say PSG or Real, or he cannot play. So where he can go? Juventus actually will never buy him because Juventus is now playing with some wide of players and they are booked on that position. Even Dybala sometimes play that role. So only he can go in Man United and play on the left side as winger, but is now playing mostly Rashford or Martial. But I feel where else he can go. And that's it. Because he is asking a lot of money, and I think for City he is not needed. Especially there are players like Sané, Sterling who play on that kind of role, who are playing really good. Maybe in City he can play. He can be on the bench. He can be used as striker, one of the strikers. Because sometimes Guardiola is using Jesus and Aguero, and I think if they play with two strikers, he can play instead of one of these two. But his wage is insane. He wants a lot of money, and I think for him is the best. My opinion, honest opinion, is that he stays in the fucking Arsenal, because I don't know, he's the key player there and he can do whatever he wants. If he goes in another team, I mean, he earned a lot of money, and I think how old he is, I think 28, 29, something like that. I think similar thing is with Ozil. I think all the big clubs, they don't want him, or they don't need a player of his profile. Even he's, I mean, Germany is currently strongest team in the world. But a lot of big clubs, they don't like to have Ozil. Because he plays he's the type of player what so-called big coaches, they don't like. For example, if Liverpool sign Ozil, where he can play? They are not using attacking midfield. They play with three, let's say, flat midfielders. He cannot play that one because defensively he is not good. And they are not using attacking midfielder in their formation, so he cannot play in that kind of system. He's similar player to, let's say, to Mata. Regarding this game, as you can see, I'm not even I'm mostly bullshitting. I'm basically destroying Chelsea. It's already 4-0. And actually I can replace Sar with Roberts. Please score one more. Pass. Shoot. Sometimes I have the problem with Twitch graphics. Yeah, I'm trying to start streaming. Because streaming sometimes can be boring, sometimes it's good, because if I stream then sometimes not so much focused on the game. Actually, I can do some substitutions. Let's say this guy is dying and he's on 8.2. Actually, Ademi, I will also replace. Regarding Ademi, I receive a lot of praise for this signing. As I said, top player. Even in reality, and actually I was ashamed that this fucking, this sport, FIFA shit, suspended him for that long time. I mean, today they are saying everything is doping. I imagine the players before 30 years when they coming on the games total drunk, and they still be the best players on the field, I mean. They are just bullshitting. It is nice to see that Pellegrini scored 2 goals. I will do nothing because his morale is perfect. It's what I can achieve. If I go that he plays excellent, cannot go morale higher than perfect. And probably key headers 4, key passes 3. Sometimes I read also this so-called Sport Interactive forum, and I read a lot of bullshit there. There are a lot of, I mean, people who are doing tactics, and I mean, when I see a lot of really bad things, and that's why I'm not so much active on that forum, so much bullshit there. So Man United lost, good for me. City still needs to play. But every 3 days now is the, I have the games. I don't know how well... how will I survive? please, City, don't win this. Start dropping the points drastically, please. 2-3. I hate this result, 2-3, you see. I would really like to have this guy in the Birmingham because Shadow Striker, I want to improve that position. So as I said, this is my favorite player from the last year. How much money they want? 33 only. Also, this guy is transfer listed. He didn't want to come on the start of the season, but maybe next year I can buy him. I would like to have him on the left side. As you can see, his crossing is 16 and high work rating. It will be insane good signing for my squad. Yeah, I forgot to download the latest version of this skin. So, this is they are playing this fucking cup. Please, Pogba or some shit, receive long-term injury. Only good thing is for now I have 6 points advantage to Man United and Chelsea. So Mark Roberts can play from beginning, he's my standard player, all others are there. As I said, we'll try to use, what's the name, to be more disciplined in away games. I'm not sure how will this work, but we'll try it. In last away games I was using that in the second half and I didn't concede any goal, even first one I conceded 3 goals, so let's see now. Don't know why I'm not having photo of Ademi. I need also to update all these skins, face packs. So this was clear chance for Pellegrini, everything what I needed, and it was on his cross was also good, but he missed. Regarding Southampton, they are very popular with a lot of players just because they have always good money and they have always good squad. And they have a lot of, let's say, different type of players who can, you can really pick Southampton and play any type of formation, especially on the start season when Van Dijk is still there. You can use Tadic as playmaker, as wide player. You have Redmond, also wide player. You have Charlie Austin, you have Gabbiadini, you have this Lemina. They are really have, you know, you have this fucking wide player, what's his name, Bertrand or something. They have really good balanced squad. So they are very popular with a lot of players. Maybe even the most popular club when you look this mid or low tier clubs in the Premiership to play. You can see a lot of stories and careers with Southampton. Plays one good cross on Pellegrifa. What? Actually, I still didn't download the latest transfer update. I mean, probably 31 January I will update. I mean, if I start with the next club, then I will play with latest. Ah, Magic Knot, I'm trying, but you know. Sometimes I win big game, then I lose against shitty team. I'm trying. I'm not using more to be more disciplined in away games. I added that to team instructions, so I'm now want to see how will this work. Fucking, you are wide player, you need to overlap this. Okay. Jota is not playing quite well. I have a lot of time feeling that he is missing. Or it's not involved a lot in the games. So I lost my white player and now it's fucking December, so that means a lot of games he will miss. Probably he will receive long term injury. I think he was already injured 4 weeks. Can you cross on fucking Pellegrini? Ah, nice that you won the title. With Hull now you can prepare for the next season and find players what you need, and maybe you can, I think you will be top 6 definitely in the first season. My brother is playing with Coventry and every year he's doing direct promotion. Now he's in Premiership in first season. He's fighting for 4th place with Coventry. Even his squad is shit, what I saw. I have central defender with yellow card, I need to replace also that one. $80 million budget, oh my god. You can make dream team next year. Probably in the, when the camp starts 1st July, you will, can buy attract even better players than me, definitely. I suggest you buy Celtic players. I think Tierney is fantastic signing. And probably he will, I don't know if he will want to come to Hull. Because he is young and he is British. Excellent save by my keeper. Now I need to think who will I replace. Will I put Mr. Che Adams in away game and use his pace? And that's the definitely thing what I will do. So I will switch command to Shadow Striker. And I will give Adams chance to try to score, if it's possible. Rodrigo De Paul is really good Shadow Striker. I think he plays Udine first year. How much they pay him? Only 7 million. You see? And I think previous version he was even better. Shoot from. Look how many preferred moves he has. How he managed to miss this one, I don't know. Can I please score a goal? After this, I'm, I think, playing Man United. Ah, nice, nice. Nah. So as you can see, I done all three substitutions and I have now one player less and I'm fucked. So I will play without Shadow Striker. Maybe I will lose game because I done three substitutions. Can I score one goal if then if I concede? Can I just, I need one good delivery, please. Why you are crossing me on the white player? Please score goal, score goal! Yes. Yeah, this type of the game, especially if I manage to win, they are winning the titles, these small, so-called small games. It looks like that this, what I had for away games to be more disciplined is even working good. I will go now tighten up for last 3-4 minutes. Actually, I can drop him here. Yeah, Con Dark, I was know that you are Con, it's very simple. I think Con, you need to play some club from Championship and try to achieve something like me. I suggest you try Preston maybe. I think they are funny to play Preston, and I was really thinking to go with them, but I was feeling that they are a little bit better than Birmingham, so... So as you can see now, the fucking injuries are devastating my team, and now it's December, always December, I have shit, and now I'm playing Man United. I already achieved 101 points. Very good. And actually I like that you signed Pinamonti, because I was even thinking if you play Italian club and you have Pellegrini and Pinamonti up front, two Italian strikers. If I play next time with some Italian club, maybe I go Genoa and I have Pellegrini, then I later on sign Pinamonti. And both of them are very tall and Italian. This will be insane partnership. Because Pinamonti is also tall, but you will have two physical strikers. Oh my. I think that is really good for any Italian club. Imagine if you play Lazio, you sign Pellegrini, Pinamonti and Milinkovic-Savic behind them. You have three up front, each one is minimum height is 190. This will be insane team. Insane. I don't know, maybe there is another club what you like, but I think... I always like to play from Championship. You build up your squad, you go up. So now I need to do big decisions, so... Will I use Che Adams? A striker use Coman here? Most probably yes. But I'm also thinking to use Jota here, Coman here and Onoma there. I will try because it's home game to use Che Adams up front. What I can tell you, I have a really small squad, so... I'm trying to do best what I can. So City drove, good. That's always good for me. I don't know, Rogic is for me also not good, so... Better to buy and invest money what I done, let's say Pellegrini, only 17 years old. And already he's good, imagine him after a few years. Yeah, I forget to change my tactic because I'm still on this discipline. I'll remove that because I'm playing at home, so I want to be... I want to give players more freedom at home game. So if you want, you can, when you play with Preston, try to experiment like me to use... to be more disciplined in away games. I was using now two games and I didn't concede any goal in a away game. Maybe it's even good to use it against bigger teams, even if you play at home. I think if I remember, Preston is having Hugill and is they're having also that left back what is really good for championship side. They have Ben Pearson. I mean, you can use him as Carrillero, then maybe later on you can even sell it. Because he's too small. Finally it's in. David Nugent, where do I live? I live in Croatia, in city called Split. I mean, city is Solin, but Solin is like small suburb near Split. It's basically they are near each other, but for you it's important it's Split, so. Adams is not playing quite well, but I will still keep him even in the second half. Lemos is having yellow card. Actually, I will not replace him. I will take some risk. I will take risk because Lemos is for me my best central defender and I need his concentration and positioning in this game. I can encourage again because need to give some shout on the start of the half time. In this transfer window, I'm not sure, maybe 30-40 million I was having, something like that. Okay, so what I will do now, I will just, as I said, Adams is not playing quite well. Jota will go here and I will put the British guy here for now. White is having only 5.8 and actually I'm not having any left back on bench, so I need to use him. I considered goal not good. I need to replace my halfback because I received two shitty goals very fast. Probably I lost this game. Fucking Man United. I don't know how much I will have in January, but as I said, most probably I'll not buy nobody. This game reminds me of the game against City what I lost. Now this De Gea saved. Look at this shit. Actually, I think same like against City, I didn't deserve to lose this game. I can go to push forward, but probably they will counter-attack me. They have a lot of pace up front. There was better option in that situation. Give him red card, fuck it. So I lost big game at home. Yeah, I'm missing Pellegrini and fucking this left back. Two players less. Yeah, that is what I mean. This is now what I'm lately experimenting with, to be more disciplined in a away game and currently working. But I think this can be used also when you play big derby games. And I think maybe better was option to go like that. And as you can see, my small squad will be even more smaller. So now with this defeat, City is having one game less. I think I lost my top spot. And now I have a big imperative to defeat Bristol City and Watford. And schedule is very tough. Very, very tough for me. So I lost this guy also. Fuck, shit. Ennis Barthi. Let me check. But Magic Nut, you are now in the you have 80 million as Hull. You need to buy top player. Actually he's good. How old he is? 23. I don't know, as I said, I will buy younger player, but definitely good player, good shadow striker. And cheap. I don't know, I would rather buy shadow striker with these attributes, who is less than 20 years old. If you can find, if not, buy this one for 1 year. But definitely has good attributes, I must say. I need somehow survive this December period. I need to defeat these smaller teams. Never mind big games. I need this too, I need to win. And Newcastle, so as you can see, I'm expecting 9 points. 9 points I need here to take. Will I rotate some of the players? I don't know. Probably not. I'm not a big fan of rotations. City is playing against Arsenal. Can this fucking Arsenal not to lose the game? It will help me a lot. They won 4-1. So Adem is suspended, so I need to use, what is the name, this guy? Kevin Endoram here.